Okay, so I'm here with Dubious Engineering and Retro Man Cave.
Thank you for having me here, Ravi.
Hello, everyone.
And we've got a little quiz going on. So we're going to be looking at kind of popular music and has it stolen from video games? You know, there's a lot of controversy around this subject. So we're not going to say definitely yes or no because we're really not in the position. But we're going to have a little judge and I'm going to ask these guys which systems they think these tunes have kind of came from.
Zombie Nation.
What system do you think that kind of sounds a bit like? And do you remember that song?
I remember that song. That song was huge.
It was massive, wasn't it?
I can't tell you what track it may have stolen from, but I can imagine that coming out of the SID chip. So I'm going to go with C64.
Yeah.
Yeah, I definitely, absolutely, very, very powerful tune and very uplifting in the clubs these, you know, a few years ago. Yeah,
I remember going around the city centre and there was gangs of pub men going. So this song was actually kind of taken from Lazy Jones, which was a song made by David Whittaker. And Lazy Jones was an interesting song because it had a lot of different compilations in it. It had a 99 Red Balloons as well in there. So a lot of people are saying it had stolen content in it anyway. So at the moment there's pending legal action with it. So I don't know what's happened with that. But also there's a really good documentary on the making of Zombie Nation. So check that out and we're going to look at the original tune now. Think of that, Lazy Jones being on the C64.
On the C64, what do I win?
Yeah. you win pride of knowing that question.
But it's blatant. There's no attempt to disguise it, is it?
It sounds almost exactly the same, aside from the fact that it's been done with modern equipment.
And it's just got a kick drum in there.
Bang, yeah, yeah, bang, it's just got that thump, absolutely. Yeah.
That's it. Well, what if I say Scooter? Do you guys remember a band called Scooter?
Yes, absolutely, yeah.
What do you think that sounded like, guys?
I think Howard can go first this time.
No, you know what? I recognise the tune, but I don't feel like I can actually put a name to it. I'm sorry.
How about system?
Well, I would definitely go Amiga. I would say Amiga. Yeah. Yeah, because that sounded like mod. That sounded like, you know, it could have been a mod file. Yeah.
And it sounded better than a lot of Scooter tunes.
How much is the fish? Wasn't that a Scooter song?
Oh, God. At least it didn't have the wrapping over it.
Oh, that's difficult. I'm not going to go with the same as Howard, although I can imagine it being Amiga. I'm gonna go with the Sega Mega Drive.
Okay.
16-bit era.
Ooh. Well, let's have a listen. That tune was actually taken from Turrican and by Chris Holzbeck, but this was actually licensed by Scooter, so it was an official kind of license. They didn't just rip it or anything
You know.
I'm sure Chris Holzbeck gets royalties for that.
Yeah.
I'm surprised I didn't know that because I love Turrican. I've played it a lot, and it's almost like they've gone out of their way to look for a slightly more obscure track that people may not have heard.
If they haven't completed it, they haven't got to the end level.
If that was the Turrican title track, everyone would know it.
Yeah.
But I don't think I ever completed Turrican. So,
it's an interesting one. Can you imagine being in a club and hearing that and then just going, oh, Turrican.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I finished this game.
Yeah. So the next tune we're going to go into is probably the most controversial tune in this genre. And if you know about this, you'll already know which tune this is. Yeah, yeah. So, what did you think of that tune? Nelly Furtado, and produced by Timbaland. Quite big names.
Yeah, Timbaland, Nelly Furtado, maybe not my cup of tea, but good track, yeah, good track.
What was the system? What did you think it came from?
Well, Atari?
You can hear the chiptune music in the background. They're not disguising it with modern instruments. I think that has to be C64. I'd be surprised if I'm wrong. You're going to tell me I'm wrong.
No, you're correct.
I lose, you win again.
It's C64. Now, this tune is incredibly controversial because Timbaland, he's actually had interviews on there. We're about to play a clip, but let's just first play the original song. This tune came out, and it was originally created by a guy called Jan Sunny, and he did it on the C64. It was called Acid Jazz, and he said he had no permission for anybody to use it. He's never given any commercial rights for it.
That's unbelievable, isn't it?
It appeared straight away. So
that's unbelievable, isn't it? Oh, wow.
So there's been C64 Audio have looked at it, and they've said it is pretty much a straight rip. They've only taken a few drums out of it. There's been some amazing comparison videos on YouTube where they've actually done it with selective EQing. They've played the mod and the original song, and there is absolutely no difference. So let's hear what Timbaland says about this controversy.
Well, just before you do that, I mean, if you can imagine it as an original artist and someone had just gone ahead and used all of your hard work, something that you'd created, you'd be angry. I mean, I'd be angry.
Yeah.
With, and, you know, without permission, or at least, you know, without something for
well,
it.
Well, let's see what Timbaland says about it and his excuse for doing this.
I would have, I got my game. I don't know.
Right.
And they have a listing. They just say C64, Commodore 64. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? So I like it. I found it. I got sounds upon sounds upon sound. I don't know what's public domain and what's not. Some stuff don't say.
Right.
Some stuff say it, it says it.
And so the stuff that's public, you just, F it, I'm going to use it.
Yeah, you can use it.
Wow. So he just went for it then. And just stood there and sat there and admitted to just going for it.
Yeah. No attempt. He's just said it's out there. So it's public domain. That's not how public domain works.
No.
And he kind of tries to justify it by talking about sampling and stuff like this. Mm. But I think that's a straight rip pretty much. Mm.
So what was the result of that? Did the original artist get any compensation?
I think the original artist couldn't go up against Timbaland. That's the problem.
Really, just didn't have the financial capacity to be able to battle that kind of fight.
And even on this video, when I put that up, you will get a copyright claim on it from Nelly Furtado's people.
Are you kidding? Wow.
Which is crazy. So we're going to look at the final tune. And this tune is called You've Got My Love by Bass Bastian Bron. So, guys, what system do you think that was from?
It's a tricky one, isn't it? There's not that sort of distinctive sound that I've heard in some of the other tracks that made me instantly go, what system that is? I'm going to take a wild stab at Super Nintendo.
Because it's a really weird kind of drum beat, isn't it, and sound?
Yeah, I'm really struggling with that one, actually. I'm not even going to guess.
Go on, pick a system.
Commodore 64.
He's correct.
That's it. I've done myself out of a point.
So this tune was actually by Jerome Tell. The beat, the drum beat specifically. Yeah, that's what he added. Yeah, that was it. So.
And that's all he did to change it to say, yeah. That's mine.
So did yeah. Did he take them to court in a different country? This wasn't an American case, I'm guessing.
I don't think so. Yeah, so he just said they won out of court.
So perhaps that's why he could afford to take them out.
But no, that's the interesting world of kind of video game music and popular music.
Very, very cool. Thank you.
I get the feeling we may just be scratching the surface.
Definitely. Yeah. I want to do a lot more videos kind of exploring this and seeing what's going on. And if you guys know any tunes, please let us know. And thank our guys so much for joining us.
Thank you, Quizmaster.
Pleasure.
It's been fun.
Please subscribe and check out my channel. Thanks, guys.